Drowning is a serious concern and is one of the major causes of accidental death around the world. With that said, not everyone is aware that there are two distinct types of drowning, wet drowning and dry drowning. But what's the difference? Well, keep watching if you want to find out. First and foremost, the inhalation of water initiates the cough response, which results in fluid being either inhaled or swallowed. This can result in laryngospasm with closure of the glottis, which prevents the aspiration of fluid into the lungs. This is known as dry drowning because the glottic closure stops water from entering the lungs. And this type is not as common as wet drowning, which occurs when fluid is aspirated into the lungs. And this is the most common type of drowning. In general, water submersion can result in unconsciousness, which lessens the amount of laryngeal spasm. Therefore, water is able to enter the lungs, thus the name wet drowning. The causes of drowning are usually accidental and preventable and occur more often in children than adults. Drowning in adults is often related to alcohol consumption, trauma, such as when you dive into shallow water, or medical emergencies, such as a heart attack or stroke. The treatment of a near-drowning patient requires immediate intervention to establish an airway, ensure breathing, and promote circulation. This means that CPR with rescue breaths and chest compressions must be initiated as quickly as possible to increase the chances of survival. The patient should also be placed in the prone position because it's the best for clearing water from the airways of the lungs. Body temperature is another important consideration, especially if the victim was submerged in cold water. In this case, they may require body temperature control techniques to limit or prevent hypothermia. Also note that near-drowning patients almost always develop ARDS, or acute respiratory distress syndrome, which is a respiratory disorder characterized by fluid in the alveoli. It causes refractory hypoxemia, decreased lung compliance, and severe oxygen insufficiency. Patients with ARDS often require treatment with mechanical ventilation and high levels of PEEP. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.